Hey everyone, thanks for joining another Juno video. So in this video, I'm gonna show you how to connect the JUNO-X to Ableton Live. And for this project, I'm actually gonna use an inspiration for one of my favorite YouTubers, Dr. Mix. If you guys haven't seen him, I'm gonna link his channel below. He did a video where he remixed Adele Easy On Me. He's one of my favorite YouTubers with everything synthesizer, music related, really funny guy, really cool guy. Go check him out. I'll put his links and his details below. So let's get into it and let's remix Adele's Easy On Me using the JUNO-X and using Ableton Live. So looking at Ableton over here, I'll just show you a few things that I've set up. So if I go to my preferences, you'll see that I've got my JUNO-X as both the input and the output for the audio device. On the MIDI side, what I've done is just set up Ableton as the clock source. So Ableton, I'll set the tempo and that will then sync with the Juno's internal clock. So on the Juno, if we go down to system settings, and then we have a look at the clock tempo sync settings, you'll see over here that the sync mode is set to USB communication, USB COM port. So that's the USB port that it's connected to my computer with. And I've got sync out set to off, so I'm not sending any signals from the Juno itself. I'm also just going to change the source tempo to system so that if I change scenes, it's not going to affect my tempo at all. And to confirm that, I can just check my tempo 141.26, and it's 42 here in Ableton, so it's pretty much synced up. So I've got track turned on for both of these MIDI for the Juno so that I can send and receive MIDI data to and from the JUNO-X. Okay, so let's go and let's start off. So what I've got here is there's a service, and you can see this in Dr. Mix's video, but there's a really cool service called Lalalai, which is an AI-driven web service where you can upload an audio file and it uses AI to extract out the audio and instruments, which is really, really cool. So that's gonna be our starting point. So I've got two audio files I'm gonna bring in here. So the first one is is no vocals. So this has been vocals extracted out, and I'll just drop this audio file into Live over here. And our second one, let me just zoom out a bit. Our second audio file is the audio file with vocals. So I will take out my vocal audio file and we just drop that one over here. So let me spend a little bit of time just showing you how I've set up my project here. So I've got a couple of tracks. So I've just got my instrumental track, which I've just added in now, which has all of the original audio, original background. So I'll play this for you. You can hear what it sounds like. So there's no vocals in this. Okay, so we would normally have vocals there. Also underneath that, I've got the same thing for the vocal track, so let's solo that.
My hands in forever.
So good.
I know there is hope in these waters, but I can't bring my...
Okay, so I've got both of those tracks split out here. Now the very first thing that I need to do is sync this up with the grid in Live, and that's gonna allow me to make sure that the vocals are always in sync with the tempo. So if I add any elements into the arrangement or I use the arpeggiator, they will all be synced up. So we're gonna do that by warping. So the first thing that we wanna do is make sure that our project tempo is set to the original tempo of the song, which is 142. I'm gonna turn on the metronome and play, and you'll hear that it is out of sync because it's live, hasn't been warped. So listen to what it sounds like. Okay, it's pretty badly out of sync. So let's go fix that. So now a little trick here, it took me a while to learn out how to do this because in Live we've got two tracks and I wanna keep these tracks sort of exactly warped at the same time. So in order to do that, I'm gonna go ahead and select the clips here, and I'm gonna select the instrument one last. And I'm going to go ahead and turn on warp over here. So now we'll see the track will be listed here. And we'll see the waveform of the last one clip that we selected. So the last clip is this no vocal instrumental. So now the important thing is we need to set that starting beat. And you can't set that starting beat when you've got two clips selected. So I'm going to insert a warp marker here, which will insert that warp marker on both clips. Okay, then I'm going to go to select one of my clips, which is my first, my vocal one. And let's go and there we've got our warp marker, which we set when we had both clips selected. So now it's really useful because I know that that's my starting point of where the beat kicks in. So let me just go ahead and show that quickly again. So I'll just go undo that, turn off warp. So let's go select both of them, ending off with the hold down shift and then end off with the vocal splits over here with the no vocals. So I'm going to turn on warp, okay? And let's go have a look over here at, we'll see there's sort of that, the beat starts over here. So listen to when I hit play. So life's trying to find that first beat, but it's I'm going to need to help it a bit there. So let's go over here to insert warp marker. We'll go select our vocal track and let's zoom in on the waveform at the bottom over here. And then I'm going to go and right click and go set 1.1.1 here. That's going to set the first beat to that point. Okay, now I'm going to go to my instrumental and let's do the same thing. So let's go over here and let's go set this set 1.1.1 here. Okay, so let's play and see how it sounds now. Better. Okay, so we're in sync now. That's better.
There ain't no gold.
Okay.
In this river.
So let's go and add some a kick drum to or some drums now to this beat. So I'm thinking let's do a 909. So I'm going to use the Juno for this. So that's a great segue into the tracks that I have set up here. So I've got multiple tracks that I've set up, and this is all the MIDI as it comes out. Sorry, this is all of the various inputs that you can select from the USB when the USB is connected to your computer. So I've gone ahead and selected a MIDI track over here. I've created a MIDI track, and this I'll be using for multiple parts, and I'll tell you what my workflow is just kind of quickly, and then you'll see it in action later. But what I'll do is I'll record a part first using the Juno, record the MIDI, then I'll listen to the MIDI, maybe fix it up, quantize it a bit, then play it, I'll put that back to the Juno, and then I'll record the sound. So that gives me a chance to fix up a bit of the MIDI or any of the any of the timing first, and then I can put that exact same sound back into the Juno. So let's go and have a look. So I've got my mix out over here. So this channel is just a stereo output of what's coming out of the Juno. And then I've got part one, which is on channel output 3 and 4, part one, part two, part three, my rhythm part. And then finally a mic part, which I'm not using today. I've got a bit of a different setup because I'm gonna be stopping and starting. So I'm not recording the mic through the Juno today or through live. Okay, so let's go have a look at our drums. So the first thing that we want to do is go to the Juno here, and let's go to start off. Let's go and initialize a brand new scene. So I'm going to go shift, initialize, scene. Okay, and then I've got a completely fresh starting point. Now I want to work with my rhythm section. So I'm going to go to part, and I'm going to select my rhythm part. And I'm also going to turn off part one, and I'm going to turn on the rhythm. So now I've got a drum kit here. Okay, so let's do a 4 on the floor here for this one. So I'm going to go to the step edit. I'm going to select my bass drum, 1, 5, 9, 13 as my 4 on the floor steps. And let's go ahead and hit play on that one. Okay, now nothing's going to play because there's no clock signal coming through to the Juno yet. So it's going to sit and wait there. As soon as I hit play I'm going to turn off the metronome. Initially, so you can hear it. As soon as I hit play here, the clock signal is going to be sent to the Juno and the drums will start as well. So let's hear that. There we go, nice. Okay, and we're in sync because we've got that clock signal coming through to the Juno, which is awesome.
There ain't no gold.
Okay. Nice. Okay, so let's go ahead and stop that one. So I put in my pattern here, four on the floor. What I'm going to do now is exit out of the step sequencer mode, and then I'm going to make sure that the arpeggiator is turned off, and it's only turned on for the rhythm part, because that's the part that I want to work with right now. So I'm going to go to part, and I'm going to select part 1 to 4. So all of those, so 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm going to go to settings, go to the arpeggiator, and turn that off. Okay, then I'm going to go to part R and make sure it's turned on and it's on step as the arp function. So what that's going to mean is the arpeggiator will start only on the rhythm section. So I'm going to sort of arm it by going to my arpeggiator on, make sure hold is on, press any key. So now it's sitting and waiting for that clock signal. I just want to check my camera is good. I've been having some issues with my GoPro where it just shuts off occasionally, so I just need to check that. Okay, so we've got everything set up and ready to go, so I'm going to go ahead and play it now, and then I'm going to go and select model bank, and I'm going to change the drum to a 909. So let's go ahead and play that. Okay, so let's change that to... I'm just adjusting the decay a little bit. Okay, so I'm just adjusting the decay a little bit. Okay, I think that's good. So let's go ahead and record that. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to record one bar of it. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and select it. For this one, I don't need to record the MIDI. I can just record straight the rhythm part. So let's go create a new audio track for this. So I'm going to go over here, insert audio track, and I'll move this one up, and I'm going to call this one 808, because I know that this is the kick. 808, oh, sorry, 909. 909 kick. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and arm the track, and then I'm going to select my Juno here. So I'm going to say external in. I just need to check here, external in. Let me just go configure and just double check something. Input config, yeah. So I've got all of my stereo inputs selected there, which is great. Okay. So external in, and I'm going to select, this one is going to be channel 11 and 12, which is where my rhythm comes from. 11 and 12. So I've got that as the input. I'm going to arm record this track. I'm also going to just put a, let's just record. Okay, so hit any key on the keyboard, that's going to get everything armed and ready to go. Hit stop so that I'm back, my playhead is back at the end there. I'm also just going to adjust it so that I get one sort of count in. So I'm going to go over here to two bars of count in, and let's go ahead and record our first part, the rhythm. Okay, that sounded a little bit out of time. So let's just go and zoom in and just have a look there. So it looked like the kick sort of started on that second beat. So let me just turn off the Juno so you're just hearing the recorded version. Okay, let's try record that again. So I'm gonna go hit that one. Okay, let's just go to turn off the rhythm part. Okay. So let's try record that again. So record on my track. 142 is my tempo that has been set. I can also just confirm that that is the tempo in both the warp tracks there, just to make sure. And at the same time, I'm also just going to check the tempo on the Juno 142.18. We may need to do a bit of adjustments to the sample, but let's just quickly have a look. So here we go. There we go. Nice. Okay, just two bars or so. Okay, stop it there. Great, so we've got our track now, so we can disarm the recording. I'm also gonna turn off the arpeggiator on the Juno, which I've done now. So this should be recorded in time. So let's quickly have a listen. Metronome. Spot on. Great. Okay. Turn this up a little bit. Let's go turn up the gain a little bit on this one. Good. Okay. So we can now go and duplicate that all the way to the end of our project. We may change up our drums later, but... So duplicate that. I should have probably made a little bit of a longer sample. Otherwise, I'm just sitting here duplicating one bar for the entire song, which is a little bit tedious, but anyway, it's done. Okay, let's see what it sounds like in the chorus. Okay, great. So what we probably want to do is add in a little bit of reverb into the vocals here and make them nice and reverby. So we've got that. Before we do that, let's finish off with our drums. Sorry, I am getting a little bit distracted. So what we want to do is, let's use the 808 to create a sort of rolling rhythm for a bit of movement. So I'm going to go over here and insert another audio track, and I'm going to call this one Command R 808 kick. Okay. So let's go back to the, and let's also just set our tracks, our record input for that. So this will be 11 and 12. And so let's go back to our Juno. There we go, let's use a bassier sounding 808. It sounds a little bit better. Okay, so we've got our arm recording, arpeggiator on, and let's go hit record. That sounds good. I think we've got it there. Okay, so let's go and zoom in, and let's go fix it up a little bit here. So I just need this first one. Okay. We probably won't need to push up the gain too much on this one, but let's have a quick listen. There we go, I like that. Okay. Oops, did it again. Let's turn off that crossfade. Okay, so go back here. Okay, zoom in, crossfade off, and let's turn this crossfade off here. Okay. And we can zoom out a bit, and let's go ahead and duplicate that dum-dum-dum-dum-dum, a couple of times. Let's hear how our kick sounds now. Okay, let's make sure that we're... Okay, there we go. I may edit this all out, but... This is the fun part of making music. Okay, that's right now. Okay, now this should work if I take these out. Take that one out, extend this one. So it's one bar. Let's do duplicate. Let's do duplicate. Okay, let's play this. Okay, nice, there we go, we've got it. Okay, so let's highlight all of this stuff and let's duplicate this all the way. Let's just double check those sneaky crossfades. Did it make it through? So let's quickly double check. Yep, all good. Okay, so let's go ahead and copy these. Okay, and I'm gonna go ahead and duplicate. Duplicate all the way to the end of my track. Okay, let's clear that up. So there we go, let's have a listen to our drums. Nice, like it. Okay, so let's just go and add a bit more reverb to the vocal. So I'm gonna put it, I'm gonna hit play, and then I'm going to add a reverb effect to the vocal. Okay, so let's go to the session view. So here is my vocal channel, it's this one here. So I'm gonna turn up send A. Too much. Didn't get the chance to feel the world around me. I had no time to choose what I chose to do. So go easy on me. Like that. Okay, so let's add a bit of delay as well. Okay, great. So we've got our reverb, we've got our kicks going. Let's go and select our chorus, and we're going to loop there, and let's do a bass line, a nice bass line for our chorus. So I'm gonna go ahead and loop that, and let's hit loop. And I'm gonna show you at the same time as to how we go ahead and record with the workflow that I was explaining a little bit earlier. So let's go. Want to get the right selection. I had no time to choose what I chose to do. So go easy on me. Okay, that's the end there. Okay, so here's our loop. Okay, so let's go record a bass line for this. I'm gonna go ahead and create a new track. Let's call this one Bassline. Okay, it's a new audio track. But before we do that, I'm gonna use this MIDI track that I set up over here, which will, let's first record the MIDI for this bass part, and then we can modify it and record back the audio once we've fixed up the MIDI tracks. So I'm gonna go ahead and record on my MIDI track, and I'm gonna go ahead and let's go create a bass sound on the Juno. So I'm gonna go to model part, select part one, which is an initial tone. Whoops, tone, initial tone. We wanna have a nice bassy sort of tone, so let's go. Sub, yeah. Yeah, nice. Okay. Remember, we're just getting the MIDI now. So I'm going to go ahead and play it first once, and then I will probably record a second time. So also, while I'm here, I just want to set records. Let's just listen to it first. So here we go. Whoops. Make sure we are listening from our loop point. Loop on, and I'm going to set the start time here. Okay, here we go. Okay, so I'm gonna let it play once, and then I'll do the bass for the second part of it. It's a practice. So go easy on me. Easy on me, baby. I was still a child. Didn't get the chance to feel the world. See, I made a mistake there. Remember I said we're just recording MIDI, so let's go for it. We'll get a countdown first, and then we can try record our MIDI in, and then we can play around with it. So here we go. There we go. So we've got our MIDI recorded. You can see all of our MIDI tracks, our MIDI notes here. So MIDI, these are just the my recordings of the actual notes that I played. And we're going to be able to use these to modify and quantize and make it a bit tighter. So let's see what it sounds like. Let's just solo our bass. Now we want to tell this to play out through the Juno. So we want to tell it to play out of our part there. So let's go ahead and play this one. Okay, I think I made a mistake here. There. Okay, this note needs to come out here. That was a mistake. There we go, and this one can come up just over there. Okay, let's see how this sounds now. That note was right. So let's just add it in again. I think it was just the timing that was out. Okay, let's hear that again. Here we go. Okay, so we've got our bass sound, and this is playing directly from the Juno, and it sounds really, really cool. So we want to record that as actual audio. So let's just hear that with the vocals, and okay, so let's go ahead and record this one. So now's the interesting part of how we use the MIDI notes that have been recorded in here to create our bassline audio track. So for this one, I'm going to go and select my input as 3 and 4, which is part part one, which is where my bass sound is playing out of. And let's go, I'm gonna play it first. I'm gonna adjust the filter, the frequency cutoff on the Juno while it's playing, because I'm actually playing, the Juno's playing live right now. And then I will use that to do a recording once I've just practiced a few times and seen what I liked. Let's also just arm this track so we are ready to go when we do record, but let's play first. Start off with like a lower cut down frequency, a frequency cutoff, and then lift it up and then kind of play a little bit at the end there. Probably like a good point to start at. Okay, so here what I can do is I can use my I can set some record start and stop times. So let's go over here and I'm going to set my record start there at endpoint. And then I'm also going to click over here and I'm going to set my out point there. Okay, and we probably want to turn off looping and I'll start the playhead just a little bit further away over there. Just test that quick. Okay, so it is going to start right at that point. So I'll just have to go over here. Let's just move our, there we go. We'll extend this out as well. Okay, so I've got my MIDI track over here. I've got my bass line that is recorded and armed. I've set my start and end times. So now all I need to do is hit play and this should start playing and it should record that audio piece in. So let's give it a test. Record that again because I don't actually, I think there's a better filter. There's a better sounding filter that I can use here. I just want to quickly test this. Yeah, it's got a lot more. I just also turned off the cutoff frequency there, but it's got a lot more oomph to it, which sounds great. So let's go ahead and do our recording. So I'll put this down a little bit. I did try that without the high pass filter. I'm trying to decide if I, it's a lot of bottom end, but I think it's gonna sound cool. So I'm gonna keep it at zero. Let's do one more recording. Here we go. It in. So let's just quickly have a look at that clip. So got my clip there. I can shorten it because we only started recording after the MIDI played. So we can go ahead and shorten that. So it's just nice and concise. Let's open it up. We can probably go and increase the gain slightly on this one as well. Let's make the gain maybe, let's say 5. Yeah, that looks good. I'll keep this MIDI here for now, but I'm just going to turn it off so that it's got no output, so it's not going to play to the Juno. Let's also turn off the arm record there, and let's play our loop here. So let's do that, and let's play this as a loop. Here we go. Loop, turn that off, and play. I think we need a bit of sidechain action, so let's go to the voice here, to my voice track. Okay, and I'm going to go ahead and select my effects section over here, and let's go drop in a compressor. So let's go to dynamics, compressor, and we'll just put in a generic compressor over here. Okay. And let's play, I'm just going to turn off my bass line for now. Let's just play our drums and our vocal, and we're going to add a side chain so that when that kick drum kicks in, it's going to be set on the kick drum, it's going to lower, compress, and you'll sort of get that wow wow, that sort of like pumping effect, which is very common in this type of music. So let's play around with that. So I'm going to play that, and I'm going to turn that on, and you'll hear the difference. There we go. Some sidechain going. Okay, let's just listen to our drums. Vocals. I was still a child. You can hear it there. Boom, boom, boom. Didn't get the chance. Nice, I like it. Let's do the same with our bass line. So I'm gonna go ahead and select my bass line, and let's go and for now we can just mute our vocals, and let's go and do the same thing here. So I'll go to my effects, and I'm gonna go pull in a generic compressor for this one, and let's go and play, and then we will turn on the sidechain. There we go, nice. Got that pumping sound. So let's turn on with our vocals. Bit too much, I think. Turn down the attack a little bit. Okay, so we've got our bass, we've got our drums, we've got our sidechain set up, and now let's use this, let's create a few other parts. Let's use the arpeggiator in the arpeggiator doesn't play MIDI notes, and I actually forgot about that. So in order to fix that, I'm actually going to use send the MIDI notes arpeggiarized to the Juno. So to do that, I'm gonna go and select my MIDI clip over here. I'm gonna select effects section, and I'm going to go and select MIDI effect, arpeggiator, and let's go bring in, ubiquitous. Let's see how that one sounds. Okay, so this is going to send MIDI, this is going to send arpeggiator tones, MIDI tones to the Juno. Sounds okay. try a different groove. I like a bit of swing actually. That sounds cool. Okay, let's hear that with the bass and with our other instruments. I just added a bit of drive. Let's try a chorus. Chorus off, let's try a delay. Okay, let's add that in. So let's see how this sounds. Let's record that in as well. So I'm gonna go over here, let's create another track, audio track, and we'll call this one, I don't know, ARP. Okay, we will select our internal track as 3 and 4, which is our part one, which is where this is. Make sure our arpeggiator is off because we're using the MIDI arpeggiator. Now this one is gonna be really quite easy to record. We just gotta make sure that our record arm is active. So now as soon as let's just mark in our record start and stop times as well. So let's do that one there, and the start time is going to be here. So once I hit record, Juno will start playing and this will be sent across. See what that sounds like now. So we can turn off our MIDI so we don't have that going through to the Juno anymore. And let's go ahead and hit play. Just checking my warp works correctly so all my tracks are still in sync. It's got an original tempo, 142. Okay, nice. Let's go add in a sort of lead sound. Maybe we can change up our MIDI a little bit. So let's think. Go and make these just wanted to check. Let's just try the same MIDI with a different arpeggio pattern and a different sound. So for this one, for my lead sound, I'm going to use an SH101 model on the Juno. So I'll go ahead over here and go create a new audio track. And for this one, Command R, we're going to call this one Lead SH101. Okay, so let's go and send our, go ahead and disarm that. We'll turn off a few of these so we just have our kick drum. Turn off the bass line just for the sake of this. Okay, and let's go and send that same MIDI to channel one again. So we'll get the same. Okay, so let's go change our model bank. Interesting. Okay. take that as a lead. Carries nicely with the bass line. It's a little bit loud. I'm going to record that. It's not a SH-101. It's a Jupiter 8, but it'll work. So let's go over here. Jupiter 8 lead. Sounds. Okay, let's turn off the MIDI so we don't have that going through to our Juniper anymore, our Juno, so that we're just listening to the recorded version. I want to record the MIDI for that little bell part because I can maybe do some interesting things with that. So I'll just move that MIDI over. Quantize it a little bit. Okay, obviously it needs to be a lot more subtle, but let's go ahead and I think it's nice. It's got a little bit of offbeat kind of characteristics. So let's go and create another audio track, and we'll call this one Offbeat. Oops, let's go insert audio track, offbeat, command R, offbeat, there we go. Okay, and we'll get this one into 3 and 4, which is our part one channel, and we'll arm this record and turn that record off, and let's go.
What I chose to do. So
Let's see how it sounds. It's a bit more subtle, so we'll bring it down. We'll also turn off our output so it's not coming through the Juno, and we'll also turn off our record arm. Okay, so we've got a few different elements there, which is really cool. So we've got that one recorded. We've also got our MIDI. We've got just a couple of different MIDI options to play with if we want to create some more variations. But let's start putting this together into some sort of an arrangement. Yep. Okay. I'm gonna need a bit more for this next section over here. You're here, and that's what I wanna record next, because that's really the main buildup. See, that needs more, definitely. This has really got to build up. So that's the main build up. So I really need that like fat lead sound. I added some effects on the vocals. Quite a few effects. Let's start off with some sort of pad-y sort of sound. So I'm going to go and just move. I've got another MIDI file that I created a little bit earlier where I just put some chords down here for like a pad sound. So let's get those going through to the Juno and let's see how it sounds. So let me just do, I guess from there. Okay, let's just get that one repeating. We're looping. Here we go. Okay, let's get that MIDI output sent to the Juno. Trying to find a sound that I like. Okay, let's get our pad sound first. It's kind of cool. extend that, just hear the last bit. Same thing. Okay, I just need to hold it a little bit longer for that last, so let's just duplicate that. That should be good, okay. So we got that one in. Let's go ahead and just turn off our MIDI here so we don't hear that anymore. And let's go ahead and listen to how that sounds. Okay, we put some gain on that. So let's just increase the gain there. Let's say 10. Okay, let's put a side chain on that pad as well. So I'm gonna go select my pad, go to my audio here, we'll go to dynamics, compressor, put in a generic compressor. Select my side chain from my kick. Let's record something slightly different for our second part over here. Do pads, yeah, let's try 70 stream. Like that, okay. Okay, turn off our reverb and our delay and our chorus so we've got no effects on. Okay, really super sorry. So let's go and add in maybe an arpeggiator in that as well. So let's go to my effects over here, and then I'm just gonna add in, and I've got my arpeggiator, so let's just turn it on and let's listen. Okay, let's use a different, let's try a different effect for that. So I'm gonna go over here, let's try house, and let's hear with everything else. Okay. Quite a lot. lot going on there, but let's see if we can record that one in. Let's see how that sounds. So let's do ARP, main ARP, new track, new audio track. We'll call this one main ARP. Let's go ahead and record this. So I'm going to play it first a few times. Let's go ARP build. Okay. And let me record arm 3 and 4. Let's play it first in loop. Remember to record arm your track. Okay. We got that in. Let's go and have a look at our gain here. Let's put that up to 10 and let's go ahead and turn off our MIDI and let's have a quick listen to how that sounds with the loop off. Boom. Let's just turn that down a little bit. And we probably need our vocals to be turned up a little bit. Okay. Let's just see how we're going to end this off. Let's do another bar of that and then... Sorry, we'll do another one of that. Maybe take the bass line out there. Okay, why don't we just end our track there? Okay, so there we go. That's our build. This is probably a very long video. I hope you learned some tips and tricks, at least till I can show you how my workflow works. I'm gonna play the full track from start to finish, and I'll go in the session view because I might mix some of the levels as we go. But yeah, thank you for watching. Please check out Dr. Mix's channel. Really, really awesome guy. I love watching his content and I'm sure you will as well. So enjoy. I'm going to go ahead and play the full track.
That I've been washing my hands in forever.
hope you enjoyed. It's pretty anticlimactic. So yeah, obviously there's a lot more to do. There's a lot of adding all effects and builds and more drums and everything else, but this is a good starting structure. So from here, be able to go and build on from here. So once again, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this. If you did, like and subscribe. Let me know in the comments what else you want to see in the next video. And thank you for watching. This was a lot of fun.